Doesn't it seem like there have been a lot of earthquakes recently? That's because there have been, so does this mean bigger ones are coming, and what can we do about it? Hey guys, this is Annie for DNews. A major earthquake struck off the coast of Chile this week, triggering 7-foot tsunamis and mass evacuations along the country's coastal areas. The 8.2 quake near Chile comes on the heels of several smaller quakes in Southern California in recent weeks, brought to life by this one amazing viral video of two news anchors from KTLA basically nailing earthquake safety protocol.
Okay, it appears to have stopped.
Yeah.
We're gonna jump right now to
Look at our cameras behind us.
Fortunately, no major damage in either California or Chile is reported at this point, but it's raised alarm among some folks that a big one is coming. A big one like the LA Northridge quake in 1994, which killed dozens and caused $42 billion in damage. Or Loma Prieta in San Francisco in 1989, which killed 63 and badly effed up infrastructure in the Bay Area. And of course, there have been far worse quakes in other parts of the world, like the 2010 quake that devastated Haiti. Can we predict when major quakes will happen? Unfortunately, at this point, only very, very generally. Quakes are caused by shifting tectonic plates, and the areas most at risk are places that sit along these fault lines. But that risk can be aggravated by man-made factors that exert extra pressure on naturally occurring seismic activity. The best-known example of this is the Sichuan province of China, which had a major quake in 2008 that's believed to have been triggered in part by a dam in the area. Because of the many potential triggers, which can include anything from reservoirs to mining or fracking, scientists can identify parts of the world that are likely to get a quake, but can't say when they will happen with any useful level of accuracy. In fact, animals might be much better at sensing quakes than humans. Just before a 2009 quake in Italy, for example, 96% of male toads ditched their breeding site in the area just days before the quake. Can we prepare for an earthquake? Sure. In places like California or Chile that basically sit on active faults, local governments have gotten better at prepping infrastructure and people for major jolts. In the Bay Area, for example, engineers spent years retrofitting the Bay Bridge to Oakland with additional diagonals and other features that can help cushion against the side-to-side rocking that can cause failure. But no matter where you live, you should know what to do in the event of a quake. Feel free to mildly freak out like our news anchor friends, but please resist the urge to run screaming into the street during a quake, as our intern Kenny kindly demonstrates for us here. You're actually more likely to get hit with falling objects that can hurt you that way. Your best bet is to duck and cover under a desk or a table, or stand in a doorway. And if you are outside, get out in the open, away from power lines or other things that can fall on you. And as with any potential emergency, it can't hurt to have some basic supplies around your house in the event of a power failure. And if you're interested, we'll leave some other resources in the links below. Have you lived through a major quake or other disaster? If so, I'd love to hear about your experience. You can get in touch with the show on Twitter at DNews or on Facebook at Discovery News. You can also find me personally at Annie Gass on Twitter and at my other show, What's the Big Deal? Thanks for watching, and see you next time.